This week saw World Poetry Day. Latest TV were very privileged to meet with Leonard Goldman, a writer and poet and long-standing resident of Brighton and Hove. Aged 101 years old, Len recited a poem about his beloved Brighton.
All the time, my mind is full of verse. Even lie in bed thinking about verse. And it's a way of, letting out my feelings. And I must have written a couple of hundred poems at least. I shall be 102 in August if I survive that far.
I'm sure you will. But
well, that's exactly the response I'd like to evoke. I'm sure you will. I may say that I have had acting experience.
Ah.
I was one of the founders of Unity Theatre in London way back in the 30s. Brighton, when I was a child, was my home. What stands out were the clock tower, the West Pier, the Dome. I climbed all its hills, I wandered its streets, watched the diving lady performing her feats. My great love was the ocean, where I swam with delight. If I swam too far out, my poor mother took fright. From March to October, I indulged in this pleasure. It was great and exciting, joy without measure. The school I attended now houses a group of most talented actors, a wonderful troupe. It's the New Venture Theatre, of which I'm a member, and I frequently go there from Jan to December. For my education, it was an excellent starter. Yes, Christ Church School was my alma mater. A brilliant young Scotsman was my favourite teacher. He awakened our minds, but was never a preacher. The other experience that stands out in my mind was a leisure pursuit of a different kind. I'm talking, of course, of the famous West Pier, which perhaps you've not heard of, for it's no longer here. It became second home to me and some mates as we frequently entered through its turnstile gates. Our aim was amusement, and we found it galore. After all, that's what seaside piers are for. I can also remember another delight, lonely walks on the cliff tops, sometimes even at night. And reaching Black Rock, I would sit there and muse. You may think that a strange thing for a young lad to choose. The visitors thronged on the main promenade, the grand of the metropole formed a background facade. I thought they weren't meant for us ordinary mortals, or that I'd ever enter their great sacred portals. But I must not admit that most famous of all, that's really historic, majestic and tall, it's the Royal Pavilion, the Regency dwelling, a most vital part of the story I'm telling. But however delightful a seaside life seems, we children longed for the world of our dreams. So the family finally broke out of its shell to find out what story famed London could tell. But now I've returned and have been here 50 years and brought back fond memories and a love that adheres. It's where I shall finally find sweet rest and peace in the love for my city, which will only increase.